How you doing?
I'm doing great, man. I'm very excited for this matchup. TSM Dig, I think, is going to be such an important game for both these two teams.
Yeah, absolutely agree. It's going to be fun. So going into the split, people thought, TSM, great, they're the favorites. But after week one, opposite showing here, Team Dignitas looks like now they are the team to beat in this series.
Yeah, I think that Dignitas looked a lot better against Cloud9 than TSM did. And a lot of people have these guys pegged as maybe the second best team in the league. And TSM, on the other hand, have kind of regressed. They've gone back to their old play style. It's kind of the Bjergsen 1v9, get him ahead. And it feels like they're pushing this so hard that it could be tough for them against a team that knows what's coming. And, you know, despite a lackluster first match, both Sven and Bjergsen did bounce back last week against their Immortals. And Sven and Bjergsen are really going to have to keep that momentum going and play very, very well here, I think, if TSM is going to have a shot to win.
Yeah, absolutely agree. The dynamic duo has been going great, but the eyes are on import Chaser to shut them down. Chaser, who's been having pretty good season so far with Team Dignitas.
Yeah, he's looked really good, honestly. Outside of the first Rengar game, I think he has been very impressive, both mechanically, as far as like strategic, his jungle pathing, really everything has been looking good. And just looking at this guy's numbers, he's actually quite a bit ahead of Svenskeren as far as the stats go, as far as gold, at 10, CSD, etc. And I think this guy has a chance to actually establish himself as perhaps the best jungler in North America this year, you know, if he can continue at this sort of pace.
Right, I agree. Chaser definitely in the running for being the number one jungler in North America, but Svenskeren begs to differ.
So I think Chaser is a pretty mediocre player. I guess he can play well around Subday, which is like Dignitas' greatest player right now. So that's like the strength of Dignitas, but I think he's pretty mediocre from what I've seen. And yeah, just not that good.
All right, well, not mincing words there. Thinks Chaser's not that good, and I want to see this because I think Svenskeren is still playing well. He's playing to form. We know he's a good jungler, and it makes it just one more player to stack up against, to measure himself against.
I mean, last week, Immortals versus TSM, it really was a jungler's duel. Svenskeren and Thardok going blow for blow, and Svenskeren came out on top there. I'm excited to see if he can do the same here today.
It's going to be a bunch of fun. Let's get the starting lineups now for both these squads. On the blue side is TSM. Their top laner is Hanser. Their jungler, just heard from him, Svenskeren. In the mid lane, Bjergsen. Wild Turtle, the bot laner, with Biofrost his support. And Coach Parth returning as well.
And on the red side today, it's Team Dignitas. In the top lane, Someday. In the jungle, Chaser. In the mid lane, Keen. Bot is going to be Lod with support Xspecial. And Coach Jung Soo Kim.
That's going to be fun. And it's been interesting to watch because there are definitely different strengths and weaknesses on these teams. We know both jungles looking good. Bjergsen should be much better than Keen if you go by historical power. That said, that can't always be the case. But I look at the bot lane, and we saw that despite the fact that TSM did win their series against Immortals, they got kind of exposed down there up against Ole and rookie Cody Sun. The fact that Wild Turtle and Biofrost were generally, it felt like, losing lane against those two is a sign of concern when you contrast to Lod, who we know has actually been playing really well every game so far.
Yeah, Lod has been playing super well. And, you know, Bjergsen, obviously, he's a monster. I still think he's best player in the league. Probably, you know, it's going to be a while before anyone can dethrone him from there. But the fact of the matter is, he has not looked like he's totally on form this season. And Keen, while, yeah, he's not going to be favored against a guy like Bjergsen, Keen has been quietly having a very good season of his own. Like, he has really shined. And, yeah, a lot of the tension has been on Someday because he has come in. He has looked like the best top laner in the league. He has looked like he has been crushing. But Keen is doing work. Lod is doing work. Chaser is doing work. And Xspecial is contributing. And that is why I think Dignitas is such a good team, because they don't seem to have any huge weaknesses. They can play in a lot of different ways, which gives them the ability to kind of catch teams off guard.
And I think it's really kind of worth pointing out that some people will try to take away from Team Dignitas and say, well, they've got Someday, so everyone else just follows him along and you magically look good by being on the team. But we've all seen TSM games. How many memes were Bjergsen in four awards where his teammates didn't look good, only Bjergsen did, and they got dragged along kicking and screaming? On the Team Dignitas side, it's not four people being dragged along by their hair by Someday.
These guys are winning lanes.
Right, it's everyone's winning lane, or most of them are. They're putting up good performances individually. Someday can just play Maokai, and the rest of his team will still team fight well.
Exactly. But one pick I really am interested to see if it gets out today is Someday playing the Kennen. We've been seeing kind of this on-hit Kennen build a lot in the LCK, and Someday has been spamming it in solo queue. It's something that he has really been practicing, you know, the like Wit's End type builds into these AP damage tanks. You can go Wit's End, Hurricane, full damage on hit, and it's been really successful in the LCK. I'd love to see if Someday can bring that out, because he has shown the propensity to play carry picks and to carry on them, but he always has Fiora Ban against him. Well, not this time, though.
Yeah, not this time. He's going to have it available if they want to go for the play. Worth seeing how that Rengar matchup comes in, just getting his banned. I saw the word and it popped into my mind, but yeah, we'll see how the top lane matchup goes with no top lane bans other than the Camille. Standard red side S tier bans, and that means Kha'Zix is perceived the most important champion in the game, trying to push Chaser a bit farther down the pool.
And I really am excited to see the answers here for Dignitas, because when Fiora has been up, somebody has played it. Obviously, that was just the one game. He dominated that game and has not gotten the chance to play it again. Someday is historically known for being an incredible Fiora, so they do have the ability to do that, but TSM is not going to be taken by surprise from a Fiora pick. So they obviously have a plan to deal with it, and they think that they can handle it if it does come out.
And first off the bat is going to be the highest priority mid laner left available, and that's going to be Ryze picked up. Also worth noting that normally is good in a Cinder, doesn't really matter though. Malzahar going to go alongside it thanks to the courtesy Zyra ban that came through from TSM. So TSM's ban's a little bit feeding into what Team Dignitas has picked for themselves. We wait to see what the boys in black and white have as the counter picks.
Exactly, and you kind of have to expect it to be something like the MF or a Karma. These are two champions that are available and can deal with that Malzahar pretty well. I do feel like Zyra is the best matchup into that, but TSM wasn't willing to first pick the Zyra, so they banned it away. They don't want to give it into that second rotation. And now, with Maokai having been chosen here for TSM, that really does open up for Dignitas to take that third pick Fiora if they want to go into that.
What's interesting here is if TSM chooses to mismatch the roles, they don't. They go for the Cassiopeia here, which again makes sense as a counter pick. But if you mismatch the roles, they say if we go for Fiora,
there it is,
we can ban away junglers. And even though you've picked this counter pick here, we've still got Kha'Zix into two more jungle bans and a pushing Chaser down the tier list.
Yeah.
So you're going to see some targeted bans now.
At the same time, though, Dignitas can really attack the support pool of Biofrost, right? There's not a huge amount of great matchups into the Malzahar. I think a lot of people do have trouble with this lane already. We saw it do very well earlier today. You know, Lemon was playing it, doing very well against Afro. And MF, you know, that's one of the guys who can kind of hold their own against the Malzahar support. So Zyra is gone, MF is gone. We could even see Karma get taken away. And then the question is, this bot lane for TSM has been struggling. Can they hold up with a disadvantageous support matchup? And That's going to be a big question.
Right. They already lost lane to a Morgana, you know, 6 days ago. How's it going to look when you're up against something like Malzahar, who's even more of a lane bully a lot of the time? And we've got to see what that ends up being. We know several of the matchups. The top laners have been locked in. The mid laners have been locked in. The rest of the desync is going to be the Nami ban sent in.
Okay.
Final support.
And Nami has been picking up some play in the NALCS. And another interesting thing to note is because TSM didn't do any first rotation jungle bans, Chaser is not really even getting pushed that far down. You know, we have seen players be pushed down to like the sixth jungle pick and things like this. He is going to get pushed down some. You know, there's three bans, there is one pick, so he is pushed down to maybe fifth or something, but we have a lot of successful junglers still available. Things like the Olaf, things like the Graves have seen a fair bit of play. There's Zac available. There's, you know, a lot of junglers that are very serviceable.
Absolutely. And with every marksman that's normally played on the bot lane left available, Jhin is the highest priority despite Ashe and Varus both being available and typically picked before he is. So compositionally, Team Dignitas says we'd rather play Jhin. It fits us better. We'll take it away from Turtle as well.
I think Jhin is a champion that can work quite well with this sort of composition, especially I like it in combination with the Malzahar. I think really that is the reason they're taking it over the Ashe, because if you can land the Malzahar E, pop out your Voidlings, and then the root does connect from Jhin, you get a massive amount of damage in on the enemy AD or support, whoever you can connect there.
Mm-hmm.
So it's all about the root from Jhin there.
We'll see if they can all land it together then. Two more champs to pick in total. One, a marksman, the bot laner for TSM.
Okay.
It's going to be Ashe coming through. Plenty of utility down there. And now, finally, we need to figure out what the jungler will be for Chase at the end of the day. And Rek'Sai, yep, that's going to be locked in already. No surprise to see her in the jungle, but that's going to be the last pick.
Yeah, totally not. And Rek'Sai is something that is played so consistently. So even with the targeting on Chaser, I don't think it's really a massive disadvantage. Obviously, as far as dueling power, I do give that pretty heavily over to the Kha'Zix in the early game. This is a higher priority jungler. But Chaser is going to have very strong ganking. He has good clearing. It's a strong, serviceable jungler. It's not a bad matchup by any means, like not anything super, super significant.
Mm-hmm.
I also think it's interesting to see the Terra come out for Biofrost, because we have seen Smoothie doing this even into Malzahar, and he has been able to get through laning phases pretty well. And then the team fighting power of Taric is massive. The stuns, the ultimate, really, really big. But this is the first time we've seen a team other than C9 bring out Taric so far.
It's going to be fun to watch. TSM definitely have plenty of team fight power. The Maokai, Cassiopeia, Ashe, and the Taric, all really well known for their 5-on-5 prowess. It's going to be fun to watch how they can pilot that lineup. By contrast, Team Dignitas, a bit more individualistic, right? Single target lockdown for Malzahar from the Jhin. Fiora on the split push. Even Rai is going to be pretty 1v1 focused as well. So it feels like both compositions somewhat different roles here and somewhat different goals coming into this one. We are here for our second and final match of the Friday evening showdown. We already got to see the first one come through as FlyQuest did wonderfully against CLG. But now it's Team Dignitas to see if they can prove that they are still a top of the table team or if TSM can learn from their misgivings from week one and TSM get themselves back on top. Black and white versus black and gold. And here we go. Game one underway. TSM versus Team Dignitas.
One thing I really want to track in this game is kind of the 2v2 jungle mid lane matchup, because I would say Bjergsen does have the edge in the 1v1 against Keen, specifically in the Cassiopeia versus Ryze matchup. I think that's a better lane matchup for him. And then we've already mentioned the fact that higher jungle priority for Sven Skarren, he's going to have the advantage in that sort of a matchup too. And that really does lead me to believe there's not going to be any kind of differentiation here for TSM. You can really focus early and often on the mid lane. You have Haunter on a top laner who can roam and help out mid lane as well. So this is something that Keen is really going to have to play well around. And if Chaser cannot match the ganks and counter ganks, he must ward out and he must track Sven Skarren to keep Keen safe.
Absolutely the case. Definitely got to watch what Sven Skarren and Bjergsen can do to this game. We know that TSM loves to put their attention mid. Even the team is named after it. Grasp Taric, hoping for a bit more laning power as well. And we will see how these teams can pilot their compositions. They're not going for the same goals. They've got to go for different advantages and cover different disadvantages. So far, both jungles going to start topside. That's a red buff for Chaser's Rek'Sai, a blue buff for Sven Skarren's Kha'Zix.
Interesting start here for a lot is the Longsword 3-pot. That is not something you traditionally see. Almost always, you are going to see a Doran's Blade in the bot lane. Mm-hmm. So we'll have to track how that's going to work out for him. It will get him quicker to that Ghost Blade, which I'm going to imagine he's going to be starting for a Ghost Blade and really pushing for that early item buy, where Ashe may be wanting to try to save up for the BF Sword. If you get a quick buy, maybe you can get a lane advantage off of something like that.
Absolutely going to be fun to see how that can all pan out for itself. Quick level 2 for both the junglers as they continue on. And you can see, Level 1 Malzahar tends to be the best laner. He's got the Voidlings, and no one can really stand up against them. Right now, it's special just attacking, walking back in a brush, and walking back again. Only just now auto-attacked.
Exactly. And one thing I actually want to track here is I have seen some of the Malzahar support players really kind of try to overextend themselves and get harassing on the enemy AD carry instead of taking the low-hanging fruit of that melee support. Mm-hmm. I really would like to see Special and Vod just chunk Biofrost out, punish him every time he moves up to take a Targon stack or try to get some positioning in lane, because it is so easy to harass away at that Taric. And if you can push him out of lane, Wild Turtle is going to be just as disadvantaged.
So you can see TSM giving the respect to the level 2 Malzahar. They're happy to try to last it under their turret. They don't go for the bad trade. They're just going to hit the minions. And Biofrost only used one Relic Shield stack, so he's got another one to get this minion right there. And they basically miss almost no farm. 8 to 11 in minions. Not terrible for a bad lane matchup so far. And we'll try to keep everything else going. Someday, of course, has been zoning out Haunter for a while. You can see 8 to 13 in that matchup.
And the real problem here is that the wave is pushing away from Haunter, and he is at both a health and mana, as well as just kind of like matchup disadvantage right now. So if this lane does continue pushing to Someday, which is what he's going to try to have it do, as the minions will come in closer from TSM side and kind of push it back, you can deny a lot of farm away. And this could be really troublesome for Haunter if Someday can kind of exploit this and get a big early lead. But at the same time, Sven Skarren's already here.
Trinket just put down. Someday's going to run. Let's see, here we go. The root's going to land. And now the Q's going to jump on top of that one. Plenty of damage coming through. Someday getting low. Will not be dove away from the turret, but does lose flash for the entire situation.
Yeah, he does. And now this is a little bit scary. Okay, he's okay now as he has seen Sven Skarren exit. But you have to be worried about the dive. And the fact that he's getting zoned off all this XP really does punish the fact that he was building up that freeze. Mm-hmm. If you can do this, if you can shove in those minions, you can threaten the dive. Somebody's losing the XP, he's losing the CS, and there goes his early laning advantage.
Absolutely the case. He's going to TP to go in behind Haunter, and Chase is coming as well. This could be an all-in for the kill. Haunter going to walk right into an enemy.
Sven's
there's the knockup. All right, Sven can maybe turn around in time. It's going to be close, though. Vital proc. Here comes the Rek'Sai. Couple more hits will do it. Sven getting low. He's got the damage, though. First blood comes through. That TP flank was sick.
That was really nice from Someday. Heads up play from him, working well with Chaser, and it's first blood again for Someday. That is not what you want to see if you're TSM. You know that this matchup is going to go more and more into Someday's favor as the game goes on.
Oh man, I wouldn't have even seen that one coming. Poor Haunter just gets ganked and suddenly people are behind him.
You coming? Who could?
And I have full spectator view. I mean, I'm that much worse than Haunter is. And well, Turtle taking a bit of punishment. You can see the damage output that is somewhat available there. They get rid of some of those Voidlings, but yeah, this TP just seals his doom.
Yeah, and it's really, Haunter is fully cut off, and you can see Svenskeren actually even starts his recall briefly, so I think he's just kind of saying, oh, Haunter, you're pretty dead. Does go in and try to help him out, but Haunter, not much chance of getting out here as, you know, even if he does flash, yeah. Chaser could follow.
I think if he had actually run through Someday, he's fine, because Someday can't solo kill him with the amount of HP he had. He didn't know Chase was in the tri-brush, ends up getting 2v1'd, but in retrospect, he had a way of getting out, but he's trying to sort of bait for Sven, and it just all got backfired on him. So, unfortunate choice there by Haunter. Maybe should have known better, but
it's a tough call.
Hindsight.
And it's also something where Chaser, you know, maybe he wasn't really expecting him to end up top lane at this time as far as jungle pathing goes, but takes an intelligent path, does work out, and now Someday going to have to crash this wave, try to set up a slow push towards himself again, and he's going to be looking to kind of abuse advantages and set up the freezes. And this is really how this guy has got big lane advantages time and time again. I wouldn't even be surprised to see him kind of stack up the wave a little bit like he has done there.
Yep, perfect.
So all those minions are now going to target his minion. He'll sit in the bush, he'll last hit, but look at the minions getting denied. And now, one of the things that really works about against Maokai in this matchup is the fact that Maokai, to last hit from range, must do AoE, which then pushes it even more and does make it very scary. But Svenskeren, right up to the top side, ready to help out Haunter, and we'll see if Someday can escape. They both have flash. It's going to be, oh, I think he's dead.
Rooted into place. Now he's got to run. He's got to run. He's taking a little bit of damage here. He's gotten a bit of a vital. Jumps once more away. There's a flash key for the knockup. Riposte not going to be enough. Svenskeren gets the kill back and plenty of action to the top lane.
A lot of action, but still a good job by Someday to at least make them blow their summoners there. So good parry, gets both the summoners, but still it's two quick visits to top lane from Svenskeren.
And it's a now TP-less top laner, so a double minion wave getting lost right here. You're seeing plus seven minions right now, but plenty of XP in the advantage also.
It's
They're trying to all in the top turret right now. You're right. Plenty of damage being dealt here. You can see the health bar whittling down. Three casters left. It's going to be close.
The next wave will get there in time, so they can actually just stay, finish this off, no problem. And that's first turret over to TSM.
Really nicely done. They let the Fiora get picked. They don't care at all. And TSM, look at that. Enough jungle pressure, and Svenskeren tilts the matchup.
Yeah, I mean, Someday has done fantastic in the 1v1, but it's a team game, and TSM came here with a plan. Maokai with some of the best gank assists in the game is able to set these up for Svenskeren, and you know, Someday is really getting set back by this. He's played great, but still, they're going to have to show that respect to Svenskeren, and Chaser has not done a good enough job of really kind of tracking his jungle opponent, of showing his top laner where he is, and he needs to start getting more wards out now that he has that tracker's knife. Really keep Someday safe.
Let's see if you can do it. You know that Fiora is going to be a volatile matchup, and even behind like this, you scale into infinity and Fiora eventually gets ahead anyway, but that is a long road to travel right now, and it's uphill both ways. There's snow on the ground. It's going to take him a while to get there. We'll see if that can happen. They're all kind of the same metaphor, to be fair. Different parts.
You said it, not me, freak.
Yeah, no. It's okay. It was the right call. Oop, not quick to land the root, but a double stun. Look at that. Yeah, Biofrost stunning in kit as well as looks, just doing beautifully.
Well, they are holding their own definitely in the bot lane, but the CS advantage has gone the way of Vlad and Xspecial as expected. Mid lane is going slightly in Bjergsen's favor, so these are things that are good for the teams. I'm really interested to see if Vlad can actually utilize the earlier Ghostblade to kind of, since he had that long sword start, he hits his power spike earlier. I want to see if he can actually take advantage of that, plus the fact that he's in a winning matchup.
Exactly, yeah, I was going to say it. You've got to snowball both those together. Greedy item build pays off to an early power spike. Also the 10 minion lead. I do want to see stuff come out of Vlad. Keen is getting hurt pretty bad in this matchup. Bjergsen picked the counter, although to be fair, Keen was willing to blind pick the champion, but it's still being done well by the TSM mid. And with how much TSM have won the top lane, it is kind of now falling to the team Dignitas bot lane and maybe even their jungler to make things work well.
That certainly isn't. And TSM, you know, showing flexibility so far in this game. They haven't really been paying much attention at all to Bjergsen. He's doing great in the mid lane. They're mixing that up a bit. But now, double level 6 here for Dignitas, and you can see the respect being paid from TSM. Biofrost is not 6. They really want to have that Taric ult available if any sort of fight did break out.
Yeah, that cannon minion gave him level 6, so Biofrost has the ulti. We know he can shield and heal while turtle to buy the time. There's the attempt, plenty of damage coming through, lands the root as well. And you see, the shield, the heal, while turtle doesn't take that much damage, only down about 100 HP.
Now, Biofrost is very quick to target down those Voidlings, cut off a lot of the tail end of that damage. And pretty smart play from him so far, and you have to think that Taric is so good in the teamfight stage. If you can have this sort of CS deficit, it's not really a big deal.
Yeah, it's definitely serviceable. Right now, TSM looking good and looking at an early look right now, better than they did in week one where they got pretty destroyed by C9.
And Chaser knows Bjergsen might be...
Doesn't look at the poison. Pink Ward sees it all. Here's the flash knock. If they want to knock down Bjergsen, flashing away himself. They know he has the ulti. There's the flash to Chase. They're just waiting forever. Bjergsen never gets to pull the trigger. Quick kill picked up. Keen gets it, and that's Chaser with two successful ganks.
Nice job by Chaser and Keen there. Three summoners blown for Bjergsen's two, but they get the kill. And I think, you know, even though Bjergsen didn't use his ult, I think that was totally fine. I don't think he was going to be able to get out of that one. Both his summoners were already down. At least now the return gank is going to be harder with a summonerless mid laner and Chaser. He'll still have that available, so we'll see if that does come into play a little bit later on.
See if it can happen. A quick pull in for this Cloud Drake early on. Team Dignitas grabbing it quite quickly into the game. They decided mid lane turret damage wasn't worth it. They'd rather take this more global objective. Chaser also going for a bit more of a damage-focused build, the early Tiamat. We see that sometimes on Rek'Sai, not every time, but it gives him, or her, I should say, plenty of clear speed.
Yeah, it certainly does. And Bjergsen kind of giving the respect to Chaser that he does know that he's there. And oh, bot lane.
Arrow lands on the lot, but an image shield is going to flash away from the dazzle. That was kind of required. But uh-oh, here comes Fensker and forcing the flash out of its special. Also, a lot of respect flashes, knowing the skill shots would be there. And it's Team Dignitas now out of HP in the bot lane.
Yeah, they're pushing them back. And Dignitas definitely needs the base at this point. Fensker was looking for the wraparound. Dig should be able to get out of there, but that's going to erase a lot of that CS deficit. And Bjergsen looking top lane. There's no turret to keep Someday safe here.
Yeah, just got his wits about him. Level 8 plus level 9 versus level 8. Here we go. Quick ulti in, half HP. Someday gets away from the first tick of poison for Bjergsen. W's going to miss as well. Still has to land that Q. Is going to be another dodge. So Bjergsen not doing full damage. And Someday just running and running away.
Oh,
and he never gives him the speed boost. And now Chaser wants back in. Someday dodging every one of Bjergsen's skill shots.
That was so well played by Someday. Bought so much time running away from Bjergsen. Most people would have tried to just run through him, accepted their fate. He played that beautifully, using the vitals for the speed up, ultimate to get another one for Bjergsen to get back out. That was just so well done by Someday.
And the whole time saving riposte for the petrifying gaze, because that's got plenty of telegraphing,
wind up, yeah.
Right? Plenty of wind up, thank you. And never has to press the button, so nicely played right here. Someday. Despite getting killed, despite losing first blood, up 13 minions and up a gank.
He's looking good. I mean, TSM have taken that turret, so gold is very, very close, and Svenskeren and Chaser both have been effective. A lot, is he too far up?
Wild turtle, arrow's gonna tag him just barely. That's the chain CC they needed. No chance to get away from this one. Quick kill picked up, Svenskeren capitalizing everyone else's hard work.
Yeah, I mean, Lod was pretty far up there. He had the Ghostblade active, has 50 boots. I guess he thought he could kind of outplay a gank if it did come, but by himself, very far up in lane, sees Svenskeren coming, but cannot react.
Uh-oh, special. Thankful that he's got that pass bomb, but is it going to be enough? Now chase under the turret. Suddenly they're invincible, and the turret doesn't even deal any damage. Now they're re-engaged towards Svenskeren. Do they have the hits? Not quite yet. Gromp de-aggros, and Keen wants
looking.
In. Re-engage the bot side as well. First, we watch Keen root into E. Doesn't even need the overload afterwards. Now to go a little bit more. Wild Turtle caught on the wrong side of the map, killed in the tri-brush. But here's a teleport in for Haunter. The flash to engage to follow in. Quick knockout for Chaser. Lod wants to help as well. This is the first. There's the petrifying gaze. Picks off one, and suddenly back into the turret they go. Someday running out of HP. Riposte buys enough time. It blocks all the damage. And Haunter
nice
drops down from the turret. Keen getting a little bit of damage more, but it's just going to be the disengage. Looks like 2-4, close to 2 overall. A close fight.
These fights are very well played on both sides. Extremely close in the early game. And Someday, you know, had that TP, his ultimate was not up for the fight though, so it was not as impactful as he might have hoped. And here it is again, Xpecial clearing that ward. Does have his exhaust, so he's able to stay alive long enough to try to return some damage here. The Taric ulti expires, he drops his ultimate. Wild Turtle flashing in, does get the execute, but then Keen can pick up Svenskeren on the top side. Turtle is getting taken down on the bottom here by Chaser and Someday, who is much faster on the TP than Haunter. Could have gone a lot worse if Haunter was a bit faster there, but then Bjergsen has the ultimate still, takes down Chaser. Someday somehow keeps getting out of these situations.
As long as he's not poisoned by Bjergsen, there's no damage left. Haunter can't dive the turret again, and Twin Fang only does maybe 80 damage without poison underneath. So as long as he can dodge the skill shots, it's working out for him.
Yeah, he's playing these skirmishes just so well. Very patient with the flash there, pulling them back through the turret before flashing back. And he's already hit his Ravenous Hydra. So even with a lot of focus on Someday, he's doing great. And this is a big breakpoint in the matchup, picking up the lifesteal. It's kind of one of the two parts you need to have success in these matchups versus tanks. You need the arm pen, you need the lifesteal. And once Fura has both, that is really where you turn on and can really start to dominate and take over in that matchup. So we'll have to track how well he's going to be able to do that.
Looking for Biofrost. Going to go right in. Actually, they found Wild Turtle, but the quick knock of the stun from Biofrost cancels it. Especial stuck in the pit. He's going to be going down pretty quickly. They're going to trade back on Wild Turtle, though. Chaser gets enough damage, and now Someday just regrouping with the team. A one for one. Just kidding. Suddenly, Keen finds one more. Svenskeren takes the wrong exit to the fight, and it's a two for one in favor of Team Dignitas.
It is. They keep having these skirmishes, and I don't think they're expecting Someday to be in position for a lot of these fights. You know, most Fioras would be top lane and pushing that wave, holding the freeze, but he keeps showing up and making these fights very, very close. Feels like Dig is getting a little bit of an edge when you take in consideration the split push advantage they have later on.
One hit away from Biofrost dying thanks to Lod. He did, I know, at least juke the fourth shot. Saw that one go wide, but either way, very close here in Team Dignitas now. Small 200 gold lead, and again, that crucial top lane Fiora played by Someday, clearly doing well also.
Yeah, and here is this fight one more time. Special goes for the early ultimate onto Turtle, but he walked through Biofrost to do it, so he gets stunned up, he gets taken out. Keen on the top side of the fight. This is the fight that we missed. Nice little flash in, will eventually take Sven down. Can't have the isolation damage up against that blue buff.
Not quite enough to do for him, but still a kill picked up. The satchel plant not enough. Of course, the flash to follow made it easy. Someday now back to go into the top lane. And Special, I like his choice of items, by the way. There's a lot of ways you can build Malzahar support. And the choice to go for Mobis is one of the three boot choices. This is the I want to find text in the mid game. I want to just get in range of Bjergsen and ult him, and suddenly he's dead.
See, it's an interesting choice because there's two sides of it, right? To me, Lucidity is the better choice simply because I feel like you have to use your flash to get the ult a lot of the time anyway. So I prefer seeing that lower flash cooldown, but Mobi Boots definitely have been more and more in favor. Mm-hmm. I just think the Summoner spell cooldown reduction is incredible with both the exhaust and the flash initiation, which is usually what it's going to be, especially later on.
Yeah, and that's kind of the choice, right? They cost the same amount of money. It's just one gives you the I can walk at you, one gives you the I can flash at you.
Exactly, and both of them have been pretty popular. It had felt like Lucidity was the clear choice in the starting days of the Malzahar support, but we've seen, especially in LCK, a lot of players, Gorilla and Wolf and guys like this are all playing with Mobi Boots, all preferring that style. And another part of that is just the fact that it's easier to roam around and get the wards, right? Mm-hmm. So you have to kind of remember that as well. It's not just about the combat power, it's about preventing the fights and getting the advantages in the fights through superior vision control.
You're just generally better at being a support if you have Mobi Boots compared to anything else, absolutely. Well, it's going to be his choice here, Special. We'll see what else they can do with this game. Still, this gold is very, very close. We've been singing a lot of praise for Team Dignitas, but it's worth keeping in mind TSM are right there neck and neck with them, and in fact, they've got a small lead for themselves here. Maokai still only 10 minions behind, not too bad. Haunter can definitely transition into the mid game, but we know their team fight power is great. Bjergsen's got tons of farm. Wild Turtle and Ash going to do more damage as well. So the 5-on-5s, again, still the goal for TSM if they can find them. Chaser wanted to split this up, though, looking for a big roam. They've got Keen coming as well. Haunter alone under the turret. No Sven's here for the defense. It's a 2 versus 3. Do they even have the damage? Sven pushing away. Haunter, tanks it up nicely. Someday has to flash get out of this one, and that is a summoner spell down for Team Dignitas.
Really good game sense there by Sven's here, and getting up, being in position to stop that three-man move from Dignitas. That is key. You cannot allow these easy dives to keep happening. This is how Dignitas snowballed Someday on the Fiora last time they played it. It was constant moves from Keen, constant moves from Chaser, really tilting that matchup, because as long as TSM keeps that matchup generally close, there's so much teamfight power in the Maokai, and one teamfight mistake from a Fiora means you just die. You get caught by a petrifying gaze as Fiora, you are a very squishy champion. You must parry the CC or you will get deleted.
Absolutely the case. And always things to watch for right now. Someday and Haunter both have their teleports available, a state you consider might just favor Haunter, again, if they want the 5v5s. Quick lane swap-a-roonies here as Keen heads to the bot lane. The dueling gonna stay mid. We'll see if TSM can match that quite as easily. Caspian, not quite the same side lane that Ryze is.
Yeah, certainly not. And Keen, another good performance he's turning in already. 3-0. This guy has just been having such a great start of the season, really doing work on a lot of different champions, and I've been so impressed with him. His team fighting is good. His laning is strong. We talked about Bjergsen having an edge in this matchup as far as champion picks go, and generally people would say as far as player skill goes and stuff. But Keen, you know, he's right there in CS. He has more kills. He's looked great.
Absolutely does. We'll see how much more they can do with this one. Keen 3-0. We know Ryze can make huge plays, and he's done a couple so far this game. Right now we just have the holding pattern, though. Only the one Drake got killed, and that was 9 to 10 minutes ago. It's been a bit slow paced. Otherwise, still only the one turret picked up as well. The early top lane tower dive into everything else happening. There we go. Oki gonna find Svensker and plenty of damage. Hard CC, layered together. Sven never got to flash, never got to ult. Just a quick pick off. Moby boots at work a little bit there. The layered CC looking nice, and that means a quick Cloud Drake.
One thing to note though, somebody canceled his TP. Haunter still has his. TSM not going to go for this whatsoever, though, so it won't come into play.
Chaser? Okay. Didn't know his own strength. Overestimated it. Just because you're an NA, the Drakes aren't easier. I know everyone's told you NA is not the same as Korea, but it doesn't affect the jungle.
It's the Cloud Drake, man. Double Cloud Drake. It's the NA Drake.
That's true. Yeah, welcome to North America. Cloud Drake's for you.
I think Cloud Drakes, though, all jokes aside, are quite nice in the split push game. A lot of it is being able to react when you see people coming for those picks. You know, if you have early knowledge of Svensgeren or Turtle or someone making a rotation to try to kind of get those 2v1s in on Sunday, which is often what these games kind of turn into, having that extra move speed really can keep you a little bit more safe.
Especially has 488 move speed right now with the Moby Boots and the double Cloud Drake. Like, he's quick, he's zipping around, he can find those. Ooh. All right, Law didn't trust the ability to juke. Has to flash away from the air, but that means TSM control the mid lane, looking for their second turret of the game. Not even a problem, but here comes the attempted flank. A couple of shots from Curtain Call. Chaser on the wings, but nothing to be had.
Good force on the turret there from TSM. Turtle comes in, shoots out the arrow. They get a flash, they get a turret. So they do trade that bot lane tier 1 for the mid tier 1, and that is obviously a more important turret that TSM just took down. It kind of unlocks the jungle. It does make it, I think, a little bit more risky, you know, for Chaser, for somebody to be by themselves in their jungle now, and something that they're going to have to be cognizant of.
See what else they can find in this one. Although that trade of turrets still means Team Dignitas are ahead 1,000 gold thanks to the earlier kill they got prior. See what else they can get for themselves. Bjergsen still stacking up his tier. Seraph's Embrace not yet done. Now building towards Abyssal Scepter as he needs a bit more durability against the two mages on the team, the Malzahar and the Ryze, of course. Still waiting to go. Biofrost regrouping into the mid lane. Lod senses danger and pops the Yoma's Ghostblade running away for himself.
Got that max speed build.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta go fast.
Gotta go fast. Infinity Edge gonna be next up, which I actually really, really like on Jhin, since your fourth shot from the ulti as well with your fourth auto attack are guaranteed to crit. Crit chance isn't important, just the crit damage. And
it does seem to be the new kind of really popular build. People hadn't been experimenting with Essence Reaver, Rapid Fire builds, Rapid Fire AE builds. But this is kind of the one that people are most coming to the conclusion this is a solid build. You know, the early Ghostblade gives you some real power on your ultimate, especially against those squishies. And the IE is going to add a lot of damage, both against squishies and as far as team fighting, because you do have to get a lot of damage with your auto attacks later.
Face plant in the lot. He's just going to drop for that one. Didn't respect the Asher across the map. Wild Turtle landing these shots, forcing arrows or getting kills.
Turtle has been doing great, and that's the benefit of these CDR Ash builds. You constantly can look for those picks, force the summoner, immediately goes back, looks for it again on mod when that arrow is up, and he's rewarded with a kill. We'll see if TSM can get anything else off of it.
Yeah, really nicely done. Just having the rest of the team nearby as well to layer it all together. They had three members. They got the damage output, and that means TSM have a bit of control. Not enough to take Baron just yet. You can see it's actually Team Dignitas able to play for the wards here. And you'd think 5v4, TSM would take that top river, but they are unable to. At least not right now. Not right now.
Yeah, they certainly haven't been out to just yet. And Dignitas finally moving into that jungle, trying to get some of this vision control, trying to allow someday the ability to kind of split push further. Because TSM has done a good job of maintaining their lines of vision, of not allowing someday to really push very far. He hasn't been seen past the river really before this point in the game. Yeah. He's always been having to play it farther back, show that respect to his opponents, because he's never had the knowledge of where they are. to kind of unlock his ability to go for these more aggressive split push moves.
It's actually really interesting watching how TSM even sent all the resources, because the book would tell you, you match TPs in the bot side, Baron's the only objective on the map, why isn't Fiora bot lane? But Team Dignitas wanted to trade bot out of her top adder, essentially. They said, yeah, Hanzo, you can have bot lane, we're gonna send everyone up here anyway, we're gonna keep Someday over here, we're gonna knock this turret down, and it breaks open the map a little bit farther, more use of the Cloud Drake, more room to 1v1 people.
Yeah, exactly, and the room to 1v1 people is really key, because Fiora has such incredible chase down potential. If you can get in those extended 1v1s against Hanzo on the Maokai, you can continuously proc the vitals, get that true damage out, and then you need those long fights to be able to take him down at this point. You know, he's not at the point where can just kill him under a turret. Maokai has stayed relevant, and that's simply not the case, but Fiora, you know, is hitting this armor pen plus lifesteal point where you do start to really become very dominant, especially when he picks up his Bloodthirster. That's when you can pretty much start to just ignore turrets. You actually outheal the turret's damage plus the Maokai's damage.
That's the state he's gonna be in about 1700 gold. It's, you know, only a few minutes away for this Fiora, but he's got plenty of damage output, and that's the point you need to reach, that 30-minute mark, where Fiora's going to feel really good about her 1v1s.
And just take a look at what both these teams have to do to kind of find success in this game. Someday right now, he is split-pushing. He wants to spread up the map, get more time to scale, spread TSM out so they can't have this fantastic 5v5. And TSM, they have two answers. Their chances to win are either force on one side away from the Fiora, find that team fight, either through starting up, you know, a Baron, sieges, things like that, or alternatively, you collapse, you kill the Fiora, and then you try to go for your play.
But the difficulty around doing that is the fact that there's an extra sight stone on Team Dignitas. Chaser went for the green smite, whereas Svenskeren got the dueling smite, that's fine, he went Skirmisher's Saber, you've actually got Chaser adding more wards to the map so that there's all this safety for Someday. Everyone else, the same triggers, it's just one player has more wards than the other on his opposite team, and this means Team Dignitas gets to have more vision, and they get to run around faster as well in case that gank does come through. The advance warning lets him maybe get away sometimes.
And you can even see TSM looking for that kind of second win condition, the kind of the 2v1 catch, right? Svenskeren trailing Hanzo in the bush there, seeing if Someday will come up and try to duel that juicy Maokai. It doesn't go for it, won't pay off just yet, but it will net them this dragon. It's their first of the game.
But they're trading different sides of the map, of course. TSM, all their pressure on the bot side. Team Dignitas have, for a while now, controlled this Baron area. Right now, it only turns into a blue buff, but theoretically, they could have been rushing down this Baron itself for a while. It's been in darkness for, I don't know, 15 seconds straight.
Yeah.
Just never pulled the trigger, and TSM gets away with a sneaky Ocean Drake.
Dignitas has the proper ward set up, too. Now, the control wards don't actually cover the entire pit, so you need to have multiple control wards around the Baron area for that complete safety. You can see they actually have three right now. One in the topside river bush, one outside the pit, one inside the pit, and that does give them the ability to kind of threaten those Baron rushes.
See if the Baron rush ever does come through. We knew that earlier on, we had criticized Team Dignitas for being a little bit slow to pull the trigger. They gave away a comeback win to Phoenix 1 by being afraid of
Keen's looking
throwing
for
the game away. Yeah, we'll see if you can find something in the bottom lane right now. There's not a lot of wards to be seen for TSM. They did ping him out. Looks like one ward was enough to see him near that river. Scuttlecrab was up as well. Keen's still waiting in from the behind.
Yeah, this is interesting. Taric is coming, and so is Svenskeren. So
Hawkshot sees him.
They do back off. We'll see if Dignitas can get out. Arrow coming from Turtle.
Arrow's going to be a little bit wide. He'll be playing tomorrow. Not going to see that at all right here. Unfortunately, Wild Turtle, one of his rare large misses so far this game. That one didn't really mean very much, but
yeah, across the whole season, he's actually been really on point with those arrows, but Dignitas looking for a fight of their own.
Curtain call one, number two, number three, and the fourth shot comes through, and that's going to miss. No meaningful damage really don't, just control over the mid lane wave, and TSM going to pretty much equalize that. A lone 50 HP cannon minion going to be the final casualty.
I've seen the GA pickup now for Hanzo, and this is where you can really kind of go for those super aggressive forces, the really aggressive dives and fights, because you have that second life on your tank. And Maokai is just that much tankier in combination with the Taric. It kind of puts you into super overdrive, where you really are not taking much damage. We'll see if Hanzo is going to be willing to pull the trigger on a fight like that, on a TP. Because if you TP away and you don't get anything, somebody's going to be knocking on the door of your base.
Yeah, it's worth pointing out that Taric's shield, his W, scales off his target's max health. So it's really the tank's support. It's better to shield the Maokai than the Ashe, and that's maybe what they're looking for someday. waiting around to keep pushing the bot lane. And after Haunter recalls there, he's going to get a little bit of alone time with that structure. Team Dignitas just want to play it a bit slow. They're hoping to not get TP flanked, but TSM ping the ward that he could show up to in the top left corner. But Bjergsen nowhere to be seen. He's in top lane clearing minions, so someday just gets all the free time he wants and knocks a turret down.
Yeah, the fact that Bjergsen went top lane unlocks Dignitas to do this. Someday knows there's not a threat because there's three men answering the three-man squad mid lane. He has that alone time on the bot side, picks up a turret, and it's getting harder and harder for Haunter to hold, and TSM needs to be decisive at this stage of the game. They need to pick their moments, unless they're just kind of going to sit back and wait and hope that Dignitas makes a mistake.
See if one happens, but we know that Team Dignitas, when they have this outlet, that Dignitas games have been going very late. They're afraid to pull the trigger on Baron, but they have this outlet of someday split pushing on Fiora, of waiting around and wave clearing and scaling to infinity, and that has led them to several wins right here. So TSM trying to turn up the pace a little bit, turn up the heat, go for Baron Nashor. 5,000 health left on this one. Chaser waiting around, finds Bio, Frost tanky enough though. Haunter locked around, but Chaser running out of HP. One more shot will do him in. Sven on the chase, can't quite kill him off. One more shot, can't get him. Over the wall he goes, but now a special is attacked and goes down. Sven's current takes him out. 1-0 TSM. They've got complete control.
Really good decisive call here from TSM. Exactly what they needed to do. Force around the objective. They're going right back to it. Chaser is not here. He has to ultimate back to the fight. We'll see if they commit.
Keen comes down to the bottom right side. Stun's going to come out. Here comes the play for Biofrost. Not quite enough damage. Nope, knocked in the air.
On the side.
Chaser waiting for it. Force shot comes through. Hits Sven. Scaring Chaser now alone.
He's trying to finish the Baron.
He is trying to solo Baron Nash, but he takes a little bit too much damage. Rise somehow gets the last hit. It's Keen who secures the Baron. And look at that fight. It's minus two, but still plus a Baron for Team Dignitas.
Really risky call there from Dignitas as they actually make the call to finish the Baron as TSM peels out for the fight. And that would have been an absolute disaster had they not secured it. Oh, still, it's a pretty good trade overall for TSM, I would think. They have gotten a couple kills there. We'll have to see.
It's a two-kill difference for a Baron. I'd take Baron in that case.
Here it is once more. Alon kind of nailing some of these shots onto Sven's Garen. The last one really chunking him out. They do decide to back off, and it's as Chaser goes in. Chaser moving into the pit. Sven's Garen chunked down to half. He decides to finish it off. Keen is on the side fighting, and we're going to have to see how did Keen actually get this. Had to be a Q over the wall. There it is.
Fight in the Q.
Fight plus the Q.
Wow. And of course, Sven was already dead. He chose to re-engage with the team, got immediately destroyed, and that resulted in no smite to fight against. They just layered the damage properly and it went well.
And a lot of those things come down to the smallest differences, right? Had Haunter been blocking for that fourth shot from Laud, maybe Sven's Garen doesn't die, right? That last shot from Baron plus the fourth shot from Jin's ultimate did so much damage to Sven's Garen's Kha'Zix. And it would really have not done much to Haunter on the Maokai.
Yeah, absolutely wouldn't have, but state we're in right now where Team Dignitas sit on a nice 2,500 gold lead plus several Baron buffs. Two members have it, I believe.
Another thing to track here, someday, you know, he has his items, but he has no TP and they're collapsing.
He's trying to run through his life. He's got boots too. He's got a bit more move speed. The minion slow down Haunter. That was pretty crucial, actually.
Yeah,
and mid lane Adder goes down.
That was actually a pretty big commitment from TSM to try to get the pick on.
Yep.
Someday, they're actually going to lose two turrets for it.
Someday ran away quickly. Yeah, double turret pickup, a really big deal here. And Dignitas able to retreat over to this Ocean Drake that they will probably just have control over. We know it's going to be TP disadvantage soon. Someday's teleport comes up in 15. And we just heard that curtain call got opened up on, and it's just a zoning ult.
Exactly.
But it means three.
I think it's pretty smart ult there from Laud, just pushing TSM back, threatening that engage, and meanwhile, Chaser picking up the dragon. And Someday has kind of hit the doomsday status if you're a Maokai. He has the Bloodthirster. Haunter can no longer even touch this guy. We'll see if he's going to be able to hold on. He needs help at this point, and this is making TSM kind of cheat towards this side of the map constantly, and that's why Dignitas is able to pick up more of these turrets. They can play around that. Anytime people go up to try to get Someday, he runs away, Dignitas pushes, and it's this kind of push and pull back and forth game, and we'll have to see TSM make another decisive call if they're going to be able to get the fight or force onto Someday.
Right now, TSM, the one call they made ended up backfiring. Oh. This one, that at least does work out for TSM. Wild Turtle on the arrows, those are mostly aimed true. And maybe they find the pick that they need. Keen nearly lost his life, had to burn the flash. The problem is, those arrows only come out every minute or so, and the turrets are dying faster than that.
They really are. And that arrow was actually, you can see Keem is thinking, hey, can I squeeze against the wall against this? Am I okay? But
not worth it.
Yeah, it's not worth the risk at this point. You do not want to be the one getting picked off. You know, that was kind of something that did help TSM last week, was actually catching out the mid laner of Immortals. Cobelter getting caught in the side lanes a number of times to help TSM get that win.
So the early game went equally enough that it came down to the mid and late game shot calling, and TSM not doing as well as Team Dignitas. Hanser just categorically can't handle Someday anymore. He didn't snowball enough to stop him from doing anything useful. I mean, this was a 6 minute first turret game, and nothing else came out of that top lane advantage. It was some global gold, and then time went on, and Someday got big anyway.
And a lot of that is just credit to Someday. He played so well around the ganks, around the roams. A lot of other players would have had many more deaths on this Fiora, but he has played it very, very well. And it's tough for TSM because they finally made a decisive call around the Baron, and it did not pay off for them. They didn't get that Baron kill. That's really what they were counting on. That was kind of the moment that they had chosen. We talked about that. You know, they had to be decisive around an objective or make a big dive, some sort of play. They made the call. Dignitas came out on top, and that's why we're back to kind of this reset mode, waiting for TSM to find that right play to go for again.
And the ideal game for Team Dignitas, that play never shows up. The ideal game for Team Dignitas, the Nexus dies and the kill score is 9-8 right
exactly.
now.
Exactly.
Where they split them up.
Slow bleed.
Like, yep.
You can be 1-2 on Fiora and be the most important person in the game, right? Mm-hmm. This is fine. Because he has items, he's very strong. He doesn't actually have to kill anyone. He just has to kill structures, and he's going to be very happy to do that.
Absolutely agree. Well, there's no more structure killing drakes to spawn. Elder Dragon's next up. No mountains, no infernals. Nothing that kills buildings faster, but he's still going to do enough damage regardless. He'll be okay. Spirit Visage will help him ignore Hanser even more, and maybe he'll round it out with Guardian Angel in another 8 minutes when he's got the full build. Just farm, farm, farm. Frozen Heart done for Hanser helps him a little bit, but he will never get back the thing that he had 6 minutes in, which is the ability to kill Someday.
Yeah. And Frozen Heart, yeah, it's great, but you have auto attack resets with your E. There's a lot of spells mixed in, especially with, you know, the max CDR type build that Someday is going to be hitting.
Yep.
And the attack speed slow, sure, it's great, but it's really not going to do that much to help him here. And Someday, I think he's going to look for this 1v1. If TSM shows up elsewhere on the map, he will go for it. But he's showing the respect to TSM, saying, hey, there could be Svensgarin waiting in that bush. Someone could be around because TSM hasn't shown.
But look at the vision. The only place you could be in is like literally one brush right there, because Team Dignitas have completely littered that southern jungle with wards. They know the general rotations don't exist at all. And I gotta say, credit to Chaser Running Special for getting the wards, giving Someday the coverage he needs, never get picked off here. So far, so good. That game plan is functioning.
It certainly is, and Someday is willing to play it very patiently. And even if it is that 5% chance that he's in that one bush, then that could be the only way you lose, right? Yep. That could be that 5% chance back in. So Someday gonna play around it.
Yep,
very intelligently.
Yep, you're allowed to play around risks differently based on whether you're winning or losing the game. Sometimes you need risks if you're losing, but if you're ahead by enough where there's really no way you lose, just don't take the mistake, win it later on. Dignitas playing it appropriately to the composition. And if someone oversteps, look, they've got the engage tools. TSM, if they can get that Maokai flank, if they can get that arrow onto Keen, who's flashless for another 40 seconds, maybe that lets them get in.
Yeah.
But they've got to find that flank.
And it's tough because Keen has shown the respect to the CC of TSM. He has the QSS, right? So he has the answer to that arrow at least once. We'll see if TSM really can find that flank. I mean, Hanser's moving to the top side of the map. TSM wants to fight. Somebody's not here.
Yurkson cut down a half HP. The team floods in to block the curtain call, but he's not going to get the health back. Meanwhile, Fiora still splitting the bot
TSM
lane.
TSM has to force.
All five of TSM, and yet Sven jumps away. He's afraid of four members of Team Dignitas. So, yes, they pull the trigger on Baron Nashor, but Bjerg is at half, and we know that Fiora could TP or he can go for an inhibitor. How's this fight going to get played out? TSM going to 5v4 this one. Chase from the front lines. Inhibitor will go down. Keen dodges away from Bjergsen. And here comes the TP a little bit later. That's going to be Baron picked up by Svenskir. And here's the team fight. This could be everything that TSM needs. Lod running out of HP, and Svenskir takes
on the backside.
Right back out. Bjerg's going to find his special. Exhaust is on. Looking for a bit more damage. Keen picks up one as a double kill for Someday. Those ones are still up. Keen going to teleport out. Going to jump to the right-hand side of the fight. Haas are going to front load a little bit of this one.
It's a 3v3. This is very risky. If Keen gets CC'd here, he will go down. Someday.
Play it right. Someday gonna run for Lucian Fierce in the flash follow. Keen gets the kill. Nicely played. Turtles next up, but it's now only Hanser left alive. And he's got nothing to do on this one. It's an easy 3v1 that Dignitas could not possibly lose.
with minions crashing in. How much will Dignitas be able to actually go for here? They will pick up the kill. Do they have time to go for the base? Minions top lane, minions in bot lane.
There's a fair bit they can get, and Elder Dragon's up in 5 seconds. My thought, maybe one turret or one inhibitor, and then a rush for the Elder Dragon afterwards. We'll see what they really pull the trigger on as someday comes to reinforce the bot lane. Biofrost alive right now. Svenskar in 6 seconds away, but the rest are 25 seconds or more, so they're going for as much of the base as they can. Bottom inhib will die. Top turret's the only one they get. Chaser gonna have to go back out, and in fact, it won't be the Elder Dragon. It's just plus one turret, plus one inhibitor. And again, they could have gone Elder instead, which maybe they get so good afterwards.
Yeah, and I think they're heading right there. I mean, someday, already walking over there, Special and Log gonna join up. Ultimate available for Chaser. He's gonna head straight there. So they will be going for the Elder, and picking up the Elder here will give them the tools they need to really go for a straight up 5v5 team fight. You don't have to avoid your opponents anymore. They could do that, they could split push it out, but this is the window they're looking to close the game in with this buff.
Guardian Angels got popped. Certainly Chaser lost his, but so did Haunter, who's just now respawning. No contest, of course, on Elder Dragon. All the mini waves got pushed in by Team Dignitas. There's no vision for TSM. Their ward's all timed out. It's a very clean take. They got everything they wanted.
Yeah, they certainly did. And here it is, the play that TSM was waiting for. They do force onto the Baron. They're able to pick it up, and this is a very close fight. Bjergsen wraps all the way around the side here as Keen was able to push him out, and then he comes in from behind. He's able to start cleaning up Xspecial, and it starts looking like, hey, TSM actually has a shot in this fight. It's a 3v3, but you have the strong front line. You have the back line available, and Keen is very low. But there's playmaking ability still, as Someday has his flash. Chaser looks for the Unburrow very patiently here. It's a beautiful parry. The bot lane groups up from TSM, and they both get hit by the knockup from Chaser. That was the key error from TSM. Bjergsen and Wild Turtle could not afford to both be getting CC'd there. They could have won this fight. Look how low everyone is here. If Bjergsen or Turtle were free firing, that could be the TSM ace.
Yep, Chaser's definitely dead if they don't both get CC'd, but Keen got all the damage right away during Bjergsen's stun. It was all they needed. You can see 8,000 damage coming out of Keen. Similar numbers out of Someday.
Solo lanes.
Yeah.
Crushing.
Svenskeren instantly popped a lot at the start, but the rest of his team did plenty of work. What's even more interesting is the fact that both those junglers lived most of the fight, and Chaser still outdamaged Svenskeren.
Yeah, and I mean, it's the way that he can be so aggressive, right? Chaser obviously is able to stay in the fight. He's tankier. He can kind of push in and allow himself to get more sustained DPS out. Yeah. Whereas Svenskeren has to choose his moment, jump in, try to get the assassination kill, and then get out of there because he's going to go down so quick.
Yeah. And he did remove Law, but he got on the wrong side of a duel with Keen in the Baron pit, and his life was cut a little bit short. But now, 9,000 gold lead. Team Dignitas looking to take game one right now. 41 and a half minutes in, looking for their second inhibitor. A quick TP flank coming in for Haunter. They want to pull the trigger. They found Chaser. A bit of damage there. And here's the Taric ulti as well. But look at that disengage.
Haunter's
just getting Haunter's in there. What can they find? They're looking for Chaser still. The tank in the front side. Haunter losing health rapidly as well. Redemption keeps him healthy. There's the first kill on the Chaser. Xspecial going to drop as well. And TSM found
that's
the fight they want. They caught Keen. That's 3-0. And Sven still on the chase. Lod can't quite take him down. A fourth comes in for Bjergsen. Someday, the only one left alive.
The miracle fight for TSM as they stay alive there. Some big teamfight mistakes from Dignitas. Someday does get out. They lose a Nexus turret. Second one should be saved, but that is exactly what TSM needed to keep their hopes alive. And it was a great commitment to the fight from TSM. They could not afford to hesitate and get split pushed out here. The minions were already on the turrets. That was their only play, and they nailed it.
They absolutely played that perfectly. Well done to TSM. Team Dignitas could not get away quickly enough. And now, with still 20 seconds of power play, they're going to go for mid lane tier 2. They can probably greed and get the inhibitor turret as well. No Keen, no Lod for a while. And looks like a little too afraid of what Someday could do. For good reason, I suppose, but There's still three dead, and they're running away from one.
And here it is once again, and they are in full retreat mode. Chaser is taking so much damage, and track Special in this fight. Special just tries to walk back in through everyone and go onto Bjergsen, who has the QSS, and he's just kind of wandering through the team, gets taken down. Chaser's already dead. It feels like this was really a teamfight flop here from Dignitas. They were not on the same page if they wanted to kite, if they wanted to re-engage, and it ended up being kind of the worst of both worlds as Keen's going in, Special's going in, the backlight's all running, somebody doesn't even get involved. The shot calling, obviously, so some problems there, and you know, it's kind of throwback to Reggie's interview, right, where he talked about, hey, mixed language teams don't work, and that's kind of what sometimes people are talking about when they say those things.
Yeah, absolutely, and it's always a mix of different strengths and weaknesses. You've got Vilefrost, who's barely played for more than a year now, Wild Turtle, who you know, individually has made some mistakes. He's looked okay in this series, but he's gotten a lot of flack before. You imagine, you know, imagine they just took Arrow instead. Like, what would that team look like? Who knows? You know, it'd be a different team, of course. You'd have way worse coordination, but maybe better mechanical skill. And you've got two teams who are playing on different sides of that situation right here.
Certainly. And personality, something I think that is very important and also overlooked mm-hmm. as far as team compositions and team synergy. These guys not only play together all day, but they live together. If you don't get along with your teammates, it can be very tough. And everyone knows Turtle is a very, very nice guy, very friendly.
Really likable person. I don't know anyone who dislikes Wild Turtle except for salty TSM fans. That's pretty much it. Or salty C9 fans after like finals 2 years ago, but you know.
Well, Baron's up in 30. And I mean, someday, still, is this Fiora split push monster, right? It's still the same win conditions that we have set. Can someday kind of get these isolated 1v1s? And so far, he's not been able to. TSM and Hanser have played very well around the fact that Hanser cannot 1v1 this guy. They have made their choices of when to look for fights, of when to go for them, and TSM has looked pretty good doing it.
Yeah.
But still, they're one team fight away from losing the game. At the same time, 45 minutes in, the same can be said for Dig.
It's
you know, they
close.
Still have their inhibitor turrets, but you can lose the game off of a clean fight 45 minutes in. The respawn timers get ridiculous.
Yeah, I would say you're absolutely right that TSM are one team fight away from losing. I think it has to be the right team fight to be one fight away from winning.
Exactly.
It might take several. It could take a lot of good choices in a row, and right now Team Dignitas trying to make one of their own.
No,
they rush down
Hanser.
On Baron. Yeah, Hanser can't join, but someday sure can. Maybe he should preempt it and just be there for the team. Doesn't even need to. Baron Nashor picked up cleanly. And they get to just walk away with a shiny purple buff.
And now it gets a lot tougher. As Hanser didn't have his TP, TSM could not really answer that. And it's going to be a Baron buff Fiora now. And you can do that 1-4 split push, shove in the minions, look to collect some of these open inhibitors, and look to really kind of fight on your own terms. And to your point, it has to be the right fight for TSM to be able to end the game, right? A fight in TSM's base, they probably do not end the game off of. A fight on Dignitas' side of the map, that's another story.
Yeah. The nice thing for TSM, I suppose, if you want to spin it with the silver lining, is they've still got items to buy. Okay, it means they're weaker right now, but if they win a fight, they don't lose the game.
They
close the gap and they scale. There's a full item left for Wild Turtle. He's just missing armor pin on his build. He's just missing the ability to kill Chaser right now. That gap can be closed if you can get a little bit farther along in this build. Bjerk's in the same way. He's got a blasting wand and a QSS. Like, not that Mercurial Scimitar is a great item on Cassiopeia, but it is an upgrade.
Certainly is, and I mean, the Blasting Wand is obviously the key
that's...
right? What is that going to go into? And someday, getting caught out here.
Running out of HP rapidly,
that's
Guardian Angel.
Going to be gone too.
Okay, can Dignitas push for the base while this is happening? There's two members busy, someday buying some time, trying to heal up. Look at Svenskara's health bar just disappear. He didn't press R, that was just damage. His health bar went away. Now it's Hanser trying to find the duel, but someday, he's going to lifesteal tank. Someday baited him, and it's now a 1v2 that he's winning, trying to find a bit more to do. Svenskara's showing up, lands the W, can't flash it properly. That's a shutdown. Kill picked up. The recall is going to come in, and it seems like Dignitas just killing an inhibitor and running away.
Well, they do get the inhibitor. At least they force the GA out of someday. They get the flash from here, but they lose the inhib. It's not game-ending damage by any means, but it could have been had someday been able to pull off some of those kills.
Yeah.
And you can really see how bad it gets for Hanser. He needed so much help from Svenskeren, and not only did Svenskeren almost die, if Svenskeren had gone down, someday wins that. You can just sit there auto-attacking.
Yep.
You don't even need to use spells. The Maokai cannot out-damage you.
Almost won a 1v2 against full build champions. Like that's the world we were kind of in right there. And
whee!
Chase is over here. I believe you can. Is he untargetable during that? You can't interrupt the CC, but I forget if he's untargetable or not.
I think he is untargetable.
Or she. I don't play Rek'Sai. Zyrene would 100% know that. He's like a Rek'Sai one trick.
Well,
at least used to be.
Fiora is still dead for 10 seconds. TSM looks like they want to take advantage of this. There is a TP from someday, but remember, no GA available when he does come up. And TSM wants to get something done here. Fiora about to spawn. We'll see if there's a teamfighter, or if Dignitas is just going to give this up.
All right. Well, there's the top end of respawning. TSM going to keep going. They're going to grit their teeth, and that's going to be inhibitor down. And they're going for a bit more. They said, hey, if it's a 5v5 inside the base, let's just go for it. Why wait for minions? But keep in mind, as time ticks down, a giant minion wave is pushing the top lane towards TSM. If TSM AFKs, they will lose the game, and it's going to be Fiora split pushing to win the game. It's a 5v4 that TSM must win. They have to win this fight. They got the Guardian Angel off of Chaser. Bjergsen cutting back so that he can recall because their base will die. There's the recall for Bjerg. Chaser with a lock-in. Can they stop Bjerg?
The
back? They're going to go ahead and top down one of the turrets, and Bjerg's going to be there to stop it all.
No, that's it.
Wins the game thanks to someday in the base. That
That was perfect! What a play! GG for Team Dignitas!
Oh my god, the redemption from Xspecial knocks Bjergsen out of the recall and knocks TSM out of the game. What a gutsy call!
That was definitely awesome. That was one of the plays where you know it when you've played a lot of League of Legends. Back when Karthus was popular, you'd see those ulties to stop recalls as well, but Xspecial saying, you know what? We win the game if no one gets to back. Let me find the person to snipe. That was absolutely beautiful by Xspecial. Right call by Someday, of course, saying, I will win the game if you don't close it out yourselves in 10 seconds. And that's what a lot of Dignitas wins going to look like, is Someday split pushing on Fjord and then playing around it right.
I mean, that was crazy. The fact that Someday TP'd almost in the face of TSM.
Yeah.
If he had been interrupted there, if someone, I don't know what spells exactly were available there, sure. Right? You know, if Maokai is able to queue him out of that, if Bjergsen is able to ult him out of that, there's a lot of stun, there's a lot of interrupt there. If anyone stopped Fiora's teleport there, I think that Dignitas probably loses the game because they've committed so much to that. They're throwing their lives away to stop recalls. They lose the fight, they lose the game, but somebody gets the recall off, they stop the recall from Bjergsen. That was just insane and such a ballsy call.
Yeah, and it worked out though, so that's what it comes down to. It doesn't matter how pretty the game was up until then, you killed the Nexus. And Team Dignitas living and dying right now, largely by the Fiora split pushes from Someday. Definitely earning his keep so far on this roster. A very fun game, and we've got more to come. That was just the first one. So now, we're going to dive more into that Team Dignitas win with Dash and Jat.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Dignitas led by Someday here in the split push game to pick up the first victory of the series. And that's really where the story lies, is in that top lane, Maokai versus the Fiora. Fiora wins out in the late game.
Yeah, I mean, you and I were discussing even during the draft phase how against teams that have capable Fiora players that you feel like the team can play around them carrying, Maokai becomes a deprioritized pick. TSM opted to pick it very early. Immediately you saw the Fiora, and then pretty much, even though there's a lot of stuff that happened in this game, the whole game was whether Someday could become big enough on Fiora to split push and win.
Right, and so we saw early visitation from Chaser to the top lane, able to secure a quick first blood to begin with. Yep. This is it right here, Someday TPing back in. This is going to get him off to a nice early lead here. Haunts are just kind of stuck between a rock and a hard place.
Yeah, right off the bat, this was after TSM had tried to gank Someday because they know the importance of swinging this matchup. Haunter couldn't find a safe way to flash away. I know the casters talked a lot about
this
the different
nuts.
Choices he could make. And this was kind of insane because you're thinking, Bjergsen and Haunter, Someday, he's running in the wrong direction. What's he going to do? And he just very cleanly threatens Bjergsen enough. Bjergsen wasn't willing to cast ult because Someday trusted his reaction time.
Right.
And he just gets to walk away from it.
I mean, I think what's baffling about that as we watch Someday also split pushing down a turret. And so this is what the threat developed into, right? You see all that work put in by Dignitas, he becomes big.
And the way you stop that is you force a five-man Baron. So in this situation, they could have taken the inhibitor down bottom, but Someday plans to teleport in. Essentially, this is a game-altering fight. If Team Dignitas loses this fight, they essentially just kind of lose the game because TSM had been able to pick up the Baron. But Someday plays this fight really well, and so does Keen, which cannot be underrated because he put about 8,500 damage out in this fight. But look at Someday, he's sitting at full health because of double lifesteal, and the way they decide to continue this, because the advantage had already kind of been had. They'd opened up the inhibitor in the bottom side.
Right.
They decide to go in. Someday buffered his riposte while Chaser got the knockup on the squishies, and then Someday flashed in to finish it. Once they killed the damage dealers, he could just kind of comically heal off of Haunter, because at the time of the fight, I don't think Haunter had Thornmail, and this felt like this split push was going
to
win after.
Yeah, and although it takes ages to take Haunter down, they do eventually, but this really is kind of the story of the larger team strategies here, is based on the compositions that they drafted.
Mm-hmm.
So you've got the threat of the split push, the 4-1, or even the 1-3-1 if you want to use the Ryze for it, against the more fully oriented team fighting team. TSM makes the proper decision in forcing that Baron in order to get the TP out of Someday, or at least say, we'll trade the inhib for a Baron buff. Because they lose the fight, though, on the back end of that, it makes it look like it's a lot worse of a decision out of TSM, but they do play the strategy elements correctly there.
They knew what they had to do, because they're not going to have a world unless, like we saw over in Korea when Huni built Thornmail third item on a Maokai and had a little bit of lead on the Fiora, you're not going to see a world in which a Maokai can withstand a Fiora in 1v1 and even in 1v2s, as we saw in many situations. So yeah, TSM did what they had to do to try and win, but that's the situation they're in when there's against a very capable and good Fiora player like Someday.
The game ended up going late, as we see TSM on your screens here. Definitely, you know, one of their poorer starts to a season than they've had before. It'll be a question for these veterans here on your screen about how do they bounce back. A lot of them maybe haven't been in a situation where, you know, they aren't at the top of the league and expected to roll through opponents. They've got to make some adjustments. But I do want to take a look at our last replay here, 30 minutes into the game. TSM going to come out on top in terms of the fight. Dig picking up a Baron, though.
Yeah, watching this was a slightly earlier fight as well, and it's just the first time they really tried to get an advantage because Fiora had just taken a bottom-tier turret. So they decide to force, and they actually get a 5v5. So this is the situation that TSM has to succeed in if they want to win the game. Ash Arrow gets absorbed by Xspecial. They kind of pull away and have lowish casualties. But the surprising thing about that is just how the fight just continues. They decide to stay on it. And Team Dignitas doesn't decide to concede the Baron
right for
Baron's sake. They poke as much as they can with Lot. It basically does very little, but then notice how Svenskeren gets tagged by the very patient shot from Laud and is at half health and then takes a Baron shot. So he actually dies during this, which allows Team Dignitas to get the steal. And as Azale was saying during the game, there are very small margins that are deciding these games because it was a split push versus a team fight death ball composition. And if those Baron fights go differently, we see different results in this game.
Yeah, now something I do want to talk about with that top lane matchup, the Fiora, Maokai, and the way that we saw champion select roll out. You see there that Jace ban came through in that first rotation. Somewhat suspect, at least in my opinion, when you are up against the likes of someone like Someday. In this league, we have top laners who can very clearly play both styles, the tank or the carry. And so to leave something like Fiora up and take Maokai blind into it, allowing the counter, seems like a misstep all the way back in champ select for TSM.
Yeah, I feel like it's kind of like you're picking between three poisons and you're like, well, I don't want to fight against that fatal poison, but the other one's going to be okay. So if you're willing to opt into it, it's tricky. Maybe just to play devil's advocate with us a little bit, Jace does unlock different styles of team compositions while still being lane dominant, but there's the Kennen Someday can play into Maokai, there's the Fiora, there's the Jace, there's a lot of stuff.
Yeah, if you've loaded up Someday's solo queue account anytime recently, you've seen plenty of Kennen games in there. We'll see if it comes out in the next one. Player of the game is going to go to Someday. Once again, just demonstrating his ability to play multiple styles, and I think as he continues to be a threat for this team, I'm waiting to see the first team that can come through and figure him out. Because even though they lost to C9, I wouldn't say that C9 figured out how to beat Someday in the top lane necessarily.
That was a spectacular series. And Someday and Chaser seem to have been able to get pretty good synergy fairly early on. Not to mention, Someday just has total command over these champions. It's not his score line. It's not the damage to champions. It was just the way the game revolved around Someday and how he was able to come out on top.
And let's talk about the way the game ended. I mean, it ended with the TP finish here by Someday. I mean, TSM once again making a stab here in the mid lane, but Dignitas responding in the moment with a very smart call.
We have to see this again. And like they said, if the TP is interrupted, TSM actually wins the game because Team Dignitas is fighting right here. And Chaser can't get it, but watch the interrupt right there by a redemption from Xspecial. Now, with two super minions and a full health Fiora, even if Bjergsen does get back,
I
feel
over.
Like it's still over. But just super clutch. Nothing could go wrong there. Even if Someday wasn't there, the minions actually may have been able to end it. So just a nice job by Team Dignitas.
The thing I love about that, though, is because also Freak and Azale were talking about it a bit, and they had, you know, mentioned the fact that Reginald said, hey, mixed language teams, they have errors in communication. Well, hey, look.
And then they pull the split push strategy on you, which is one of the hardest execution complexity compositions there is.
Exactly. So, you know, it really excites me to see a team like Dignitas that had tons of hype around the individuals being picked up on the roster coming in, but then see them also reject some of these some of these criticisms thrown at them, like, oh, well, they're not going to be able to communicate. They're not going to be able to operate, you know, in tip-top shape right off the bat. Well, they look good so far. When we come back, we'll see if TSM can tie up the series in Game 2. More LCS action when we return.
Hell yeah, let's fucking go, guys!
That's what I'm
saying. I wanna see some clean gameplay!
I don't give a fuck if it's clean. I just want blood.
Daunt's gonna walk right into an enemy. Sven, there's the knockup. Alright, Sven can maybe turn around in time. It's gonna be close though. Vital proc. Here comes the Rek'Sai. Couple hits will do it. Summoner getting low. He's got the damage though. First blood comes through. That TP flank was sick.
Nice.
I'm leaving.
Okay, nice.
And here comes the TP a little bit later. That's going to be Baron picked up by Svenskeren. Here's the team fight. This could be everything that TSM needs. Lot running out of HP and Svenskeren takes it out. Side right back out. Bjerg's going to find a special. Exhaust is on. Looking for a bit more damage. Keen picks up one as a double kill for Someday.
Mouse, go, 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 go